How did you like your matches with Meng and Barbarian in WCW?
Great. Meng is one of the two of the greatest guys in this world, Meng and Barbarian. But Meng's one of the guys you don't want to get pissed off at, you know, on the other side. I remember Meng one time. Meng used to wrestle in Montreal for the Rougeaus.
Right.
And I remember Hawk and I would go up there for the Rougeaus, and we were heels. And one time, we were beating the dog snot out of Jacques Rougeau and his brothers, Raymond and the other kid. I forget the other kid's name.
Armand.
We were beating up all three of them, had them all three bloody in the ring land, and we called down Meng. Come on down. That was Meng had a big angle against the Rougeaus. Come on, Meng, let's go kill him. And we're Hawk and I are holding each arm like this, holding Jacques by the back of the hair like this. And Meng stand there. Meng thrust kicks me and thrust kicks Hawk. Now we flew over the top rope for him, right? Now Meng is a stone cold baby face in the middle of the ring with Rougeaus. We sold out that whole summer wherever we went for the Rougeaus just because of that. Meng was a big, impressive guy.
Did you ever see him in action in any of the bar fights?
Oh, yeah. I saw him in East St. Louis one time. Kurt Hennig, who was another guy that did this, stirring the pot, good river, did it at this place called the Oz Disco in East St. Louis, which is a place you don't want to get caught messing around in. And, I saw Meng have his finger behind the guy's eye and pull his eye out and say, "You don't stop, brother, I'm going to eat this eye." And he was dead serious. He had about 10 beers in him, you know, half lit, and the guy messed up. And Meng had this, like, freakish power. He may not have been a guy that benched 800 pounds, right, but he was just a freak. Like Dr. Steve Williams, same way. Just freak strong, out of the blue.